In Germany, authorities are on the scene of one of the world's oldest museums where thieves have carried off a major heist. Early this morning, a glass display case was smashed and millions of dollars worth of 18th century jewelry was stolen from the Green Vault in Dresden. Police say two suspects were captured on surveillance footage entering through a window. Now, this museum contains about 4,000 objects of gold, precious stones, and other materials. Museum officials say it will be impossible to sell those things on the open market. With more on this, I'm joined by Robert Wittman. He's an art security consultant and former FBI on the art crime team. Robert, good morning. So glad you could be with us. First of all, your reaction to this brazen heist?
I think it's awful. It's terrible when our cultural heritage is stolen. It's terrible when because of the fact that there's a possibility it might be destroyed or damaged. So these types of things are really crimes against all of humanity, not just the Dresden Museum, but all of us.
What's the historical significance of these pieces of jewelry?
Oh, they're some of the oldest pieces that we still have. They were made specifically for the king. They're fantastic. They're beautiful pieces. And, you know, the problem with a heist like this, from what I've seen in the past, is that at times when people steal jewelry, unlike art, which has to be kept in a very good condition, it can't be dismantled or taken apart or destroyed or cut up, jewelry can be dismantled. And so, you know, the value of these pieces is based upon the historical context. And if these individuals start to pop the diamond and start taking out the different stones and melting the metals, the value is lost. But more importantly, the history is lost.
The history is lost. Okay, so for those experts who have said you can't sell any of this, what could be done is, as you're pointing out, take it apart, and then it could be sold.
Yeah, which is really the sin here. That would be the real tragedy if something like that happens. Hopefully these individuals who took these pieces know what they have. And, you know, I have enough common sense to be able to want to keep them together, you know, for the historical context and for the value.
If you were investigating this crime, where would you begin?
Well, it's always an issue of looking at the ubiquitous technical surveillance that's available. That's really what it's referred to today, and that's surveillance from all over. The crimes had occurred around 5 a.m. in the morning in the area. There's probably not a lot of traffic at that point. So surveillance cameras, which are everywhere today, would be what we would look at right off the bat to see where the individuals came from, not just at the museum, but in all the roads leading to the museum, all in a circle around the museum. And then, of course, to do something like this, from what I understand, there was a lot of technical material. They had to break through a window. They had to cut off supposedly the alarm system or electrical outlets or the electrical system. All of that is evidentiary. So all of that's going to lead to evidence. So all of that will create leads for the investigators.
At the risk of sounding like I'm in a movie, do you think this was an inside job?
Well, you know, in the United States, we've done a study with that in the FBI, and we found that about 89% of museum thefts in the United States were inside jobs. They had some aspect.
89%?
89% of museum thefts. Now, that doesn't mean that it's always an employee. It could be someone who just has knowledge of the systems within the museum, which allowed them to overcome those systems. But 89% of the time, when it's a museum heist, it's someone who has the keys to the kingdom that's involved.
Wow. Robert, how much confidence do you have that these thieves will be tracked down?
Well, as I say, you know, I think that we'll catch them. I think that the investigators in Dresden will catch these thieves. Ultimately, that'll happen. The question is whether or not the thieves destroy the artwork, destroy the jewelry. That we have to hold our fingers crossed and say a prayer that that doesn't happen.
And, you know, whenever we hear a story like this, people say, how could this happen? Wasn't there, you know, levels of security that would just be impenetrable?
Yes, but, you know, you have to understand that, you know, all security can be overcome. It depends on how brazen the thieves want to be. Ultimately, you know, you can have human resources, you can have guards, you can have good alarm systems and surveillance. But if the thieves are brazen and they have inside help, those things can be overcome one by one. And ultimately, it depends on how far they want to go.
Robert Wittman, you're the perfect guest to talk about this today. Robert is an art security consultant and former FBI agent on the art crime team. Thank you so much.